Traders, I'm done for the day and I'm done for the week. And as you can see here, I've got four winners. mRNA is one of them. ZM, of course, I shouldn't count that. It's a very small winner. I moved out probably before I should have. NCLH and space. So I've got four out of four. Yesterday, I had four out of four. The day before, I had five out of five. So I've got 13 trades in a row without a loser. Stop following me. Seriously, traders, stop following me. If I would take another trade, just don't do it. I never had 13 in a row. I don't remember that. Anyway, it's a great result and I'm very happy to have it. But you know, it's very, very rare. It's extremely rare. I really don't remember the last time I had 13 green trades in a row, three green trades like days like this. I just don't remember this. Anyway, a very nice day, and let's take a look at some of my trades here. One of them is extremely important, same as we had yesterday. So I'm just going to concentrate on this one really, which is space. But let me quickly go through mRNA. Now, look at the way mRNA behaves. It started slightly in green, but as you can see, it was very weak throughout the day. I'm still following it. I'm still short. I took it late. At that point, when we've seen that the market is likely to come down under the lows, the S&P 500 is likely to come under the lows. In fact, that was the first move that was made by the Nasdaq. The Nasdaq came down first under the lows. That was the point where we took mRNA under the lows. So we kind of thought, well, it's likely that the S&P will follow the Nasdaq. It took it some time. Now it came down under the lows. That's why I think ZM is likely to reach my planned initial target, although I did not hold for it. So mRNA was a continuation of a stock that was relatively weak. And again, if you want to short something, short a stock that is relatively weak. Don't short a stock that is uptrending and it's high and you think like it's going to crash. Just look at mRNA. It's extremely weak. Look at the daily of mRNA. It's also extremely weak and it worked out fine. Less interesting is NCLH. It was a classic gap and go, started with a very big gap up. It was one of my first pre-market picks, and it just did what it was expected to do. The most interesting one is space. And I will just continue and say what I said yesterday. I'm going to repeat what I said yesterday, and I'm going to repeat saying that 10 times more or 100 times more until all of you finally get the idea of never move out on a spike. I don't know how many times I said that, and it's okay to move out on a spike if you're new to trading. It's definitely not okay to move out on a spike if you're an experienced trader. I would call you experienced even if you are still possibly losing money. Let's say if you're trading over a year, you are in my understanding an experienced trader. You may be experienced in losing money, but you're still having some experience. You're not as afraid as you were when you moved into trading. And what do I mean by that? When you just start trading, and I definitely remember how I started, at the beginning, you gotta have a hard stop. You must have a hard stop. You're afraid from anything that just may happen. You're afraid that you're gonna lose all your money in a few seconds. And at the beginning, you're right. You don't know what to expect. You don't know what volatility to expect. You don't know what's going to happen after you click the button. So yes, you must have hard stops when you're starting out. I believe it shouldn't be more than 6 months, maybe 1 year. You must have hard stop. It helps you mentally. If it helps you mentally, you're okay with this. That's the way to start. But if you do know about the market and you do have some experience over 6 months or over a year, take a look at what happened to space. Space was a gap and go. Started with a big gap down, just like NCLH. It was one of my two main candidates for a short today. So I was watching space, actually one of my four candidates for a short today. I was watching space and it tried to move higher. It came down. That was the right thing to do. I shorted it at the third 1 minute candle. And right after I shorted, well, initially it came down under the lows, which looked fine, but then it spiked up like crazy. This is a 1 minute candle, but and you can see that during this 1 minute, it spiked up like crazy. In fact, during this minute, it took it maybe 30 seconds to spike, and then it held up to the highs. It was an amazing spike that should have taken me out if I had a hard stop. And since it moved up so quickly, it's usually just one buyer who's buying a quantity that just drives the stock up. You know, definitely space has more sellers than windows today, than buyers today. Look at the behavior. But if the buyers are coming in just at one stop, or even one buyer's coming in, one big buyer's coming in at just one point, then this one buyer, or maybe a few, could take you out on a spike. So you look at the stock moving up. Stop should have been somewhere over here, over 29.20. It moved up to 29.60, and you look at the stock moving up 40 cents over a stop loss, which is double my stop loss. I had a 40 cents stop loss, and it was double my stop loss. And you do not move out. You hang on there. You just wait for it to calm down. And then you look at the way it's spiking up, you pray that it will stop. You don't know if it's going to stop. It could continue points higher, right? Normally not. It could. And I do remember one time it happened to me years ago. But normally, and really, moving 40 cents over my planned stop loss was quite a lot. Okay, double my stop loss. Double my stop loss. I shouldn't say more than that. Double my stop loss is a lot of money. So this stock moved up 40 cents over my stop loss, and I just watched it, and I was praying that it's going to stop and start coming down, and I knew I shouldn't move out. And then the thing you need to do is just wait a little bit. Wait for, you know, the first move up was very fast. And then you just wait for a pullback. So it moved up like 40 cents too much. And then it came down like 10 cents. So at the point where it came down like 10, 15 cents, you at that point, you know that the buyer is probably out. The one who, the fat finger is probably out. The one who just pushed it higher is probably out, because it cooled down a little bit. And then if it just cooled down a little bit, moved down 10, 15 cents, and then moved over the highs, then you move out. And now you have a double stop loss. So you actually lost, possibly, it didn't happen, of course, it came down nicely. But let's just imagine now you have a double stop loss. It moved up another 40 cents and now it pulled back down a little bit. And if it was just one buyer, it's likely to come down, and it did come down. But let's say it's not just one buyer. Let's say something happened. Let's have some intraday news. Let's say all of the people just decided now they're going to buy space. The market's moving up, whatever. Then now, let's just imagine that you move out once it cooled down and pulled back down a little bit, and then you move out over the highs, fine, and now you have a double stop loss. So in fact, you just lost two trades instead of losing just one. You just had a double stop loss. Two risk points just went down the drain. So, you know, so I'm saying the following. Let's just assume that I'm right. Let's just assume that you have to wait and you shouldn't move out when it spikes. And let's assume that more than 50% of the spikes are actually getting back to the point where you could move out at a profit, or move out at your planned stop loss, or even better. Let's just say that in 50% of the cases I'm right. You already, if you're going to implement that, when it's just 50%, you're already in profit. Or you know what? You're not losing your double stop loss. But I'm right more than this. I'm right probably 70 or 80% of the time. When the stock is spiking and you hang on to it, your chance to become a winner is approximately, or you know what, a smaller loser is approximately 70 or 80%. I'm not absolutely sure about this number, okay? But it's very, very high. Your chance to be moving out of the high is still there, but then you have, let's say, two losing trades instead of one. But if you put in the large numbers, all the spikes you're going to get throughout the next year. And we had another example like this. We had it yesterday. Just look at the video I made yesterday. I made a video yesterday stressing exactly this point. I can't remember the stock. But exactly that point. We talked about it yesterday. We mentioned it in the trading room. And I did say the exact same things I'm saying today. So just never move out on a spike. Look, it spiked up, it cooled down, it held a little bit, and then one of my best winners today. Look at the way it moved out. These spikes take you out of fantastic trades. Don't let them do that. That's why you shouldn't have a hard stop in the system. You need to have a mental stop. Hang on by your teeth. Just watch it, pray. I don't know what you're going to do. I don't care what you believe in. Just pray to your God and just wait for it to come down again. That's right for a short trade. That's right for a long trade. Just hang on out there. And if it does go against you, yeah, have a bigger stop loss than you imagined. Right, sometimes much bigger. But at the end of the year, it doesn't take a year, it takes a month. At the end of the month, think about all the spikes that took you out. Think about that. And, you know, just add that number and you will see that you're making money. You're making money by not moving out on spikes. I'm going to say that at least another 10 times, okay? I'm going to repeat this exact same speech I just had for another 10 times, at least in the next year, okay? So if that makes you bored, that's fine by me, because the longer I will keep on saying that, sometimes it will, you know, sink into your memory and you will be there and you will do that, and sometime in the future it's going to help you out. It may take time. It took me time. It's just, you know, to get the courage to hang on to something that looks like that, you need some courage, and just think, it took me a long time to realize that that's what I should do and really believe in it and do it. You know, it takes time, so it will take you to hang on there. That's it, traders. We had a fantastic week. I know many of you guys joined us with this very, very nice week we had. And really appreciate the fact that you've been with us. And we're here, we're trading, we're learning, and we're enjoying. And the most important part, we're enjoying. So hang on, try to become a trader. It's the best profession in the world, probably the hardest profession in the world, but also the best profession in the world if you make it. And if you're on YouTube, we will really appreciate if you give us a thumb up. I think we earned it today. And even if we didn't, it's our trading, our free trading room out there, and you guys are enjoying it for free. So the only thing we're asking really is just a thumb up. So please help us with that. And just have a perfect weekend, traders. Enjoy your weekend, and I'll be very happy to see you here next week. Have a great weekend. Bye, traders.